mean the ones that are on the bottom of the stream layout are from last round, but that was not low special attack. Red means that it's boosted, blue means that it's hindered, so plus special attack minus speed SVM. I don't think that choice of colors was quite right, but I mean, get used to it. I think green is plus and red is minus, so... And blue is, like, could be minus, sure, but... I guess I would have done just green and red, or... Not colors, but it's, once you're used to it, and you know the natures anyway, it's fine. If people ran Typhlosion, would you... You mean reset for mild Espeon? Why? Why would mild Espeon hold that? And if you mean mild Quava, like, wouldn't you rather have quiet or rash? Because those purify it better? Or even modest, if you could just get through the terrible early game? Yeah, mild is the worst. It's in the bottom tier of natures to purify. No, rash is faster with call strats. Oh, hello. That is a good Espeon. Blue speed, hidden power, fire. A good croc for Lab Torrent. Yeah, like all of this, well, quiet purifies okay, but the other plus special attack nature is modest, mild, and rash. Require you to call. You can't just go through the battles and expect to get enough experience or have the shadow bar emptied by the time you need to purify. So mild was 3 calls. Rash, I think, is 2. I'm pretty sure rash is 2. Modest, I've never tried because minus attack gives a reset. But I, according to the notes on purification methods, I think modest is like 3. Better than the last one, though. Thank you. Yeah, the main thing is just... You would be resetting so often for, like, a guava that got enough experience, and... Like, I don't even... The strats could be... I forget when you get your moves, but, like... Try to get the bar empty before Relic Forest, and then you can, like, flame wheel stuff there. I don't know, get Blaze from the first spot. Like, you just have to rework everything, but I think because a lot of the good natures are hard to purify, and experience is so crucial for Mount Battle, and for later. And... Some fights are really rough. Even, you know, besides Vermite, like, you would just... It would just not be that fun. And then, like, it would be more of a hidden power grind than what we have now. Now is just... Okay, I'm gonna start moving up there. Now is, like, there's no run... Or, it's very reasonable to get a run that has no hidden powers, but it's still, like, a really good start, and you're really excited for the run, and I can get a good time. And my PB had... double hidden power, but I could easily beat my PB by 2 or 3 minutes without a hidden power. I feel like with a Typhlosion route, you would just be not engaged with your run if you didn't have something to deal with, like Rhydon and Growlithe and Tyranitar. Like, that didn't get HP water, grass, or ice. Reset. But it also might just be, like, you have to hit that many more fire blasts. However many pokes you'd hit in power, just fire blast does more anyway at the point. This is a good Espeon, but it's not pretty. Earlier, if we found a strat for Burma, I would try running Typhlosion probably. Like, right now, the best strat I can think of is turn one, switch to Umbreon, and then just slowly but surely chip away. Or, you know, switch to Umbreon and then just target the Mantine, and then when the Mantine is dead, or basically on the turn that Mantine can die to a Shadow Rush, you switch Kulava back in and then Shadow Rush it and hope you don't crit. Hope you crit, otherwise runs over. No. Because you don't really want Espeon and Umbreon in that fight, because then Espeon just gets ganged up on. And Umbreon can't damage anything in that fight. Doesn't even have Helping Hand. I mean, you'd probably just, like, glitch X Special. But the problem is that you can't just have Umbreon in slot 1 for the start, because there's one fight before it where Quilava is good enough. Maybe it might outspeed the Love Disc, maybe. Nice movement, maybe. So, yeah, you have Quilava in front so it can get experience and make the previous fight faster, and then it's gotta come out immediately because it just always, pretty much always dies to Mantine turn 1. But then it's probably gotta come back in at some point so that the AI doesn't just destroy Espeon. And so that it can get more experience, and maybe the Shadow Bar can go down, and so yeah, you can kill things faster. But that's not really a good strat. I'm too excited to do that. I guess that's nice, because then Bubble Beam doesn't hit Espeon, so you might not have to kill Espeon during the fight, but you probably still would because of how slow it is to switch to a Pokemon that you're not even going to attack with. Bad. I actually wonder if you would use Quilava for Mirror B and just suicide it, because it would die, like, every time. I mean, it would outspeed the 31 and the 30, but it would just, like, get one hit by Water Gun. It actually would get one hit by Water Gun. First time that it gets hit with Water Gun or Dive. Well, if it gets Dive, you could switch, but if it gets Water Gun, it's just like dead. And Astonish would do some damage too. And, you know, you don't really care if it's in Hyper Mode for Relic Forest, because that Hyper Mode can just Flame Wheel Cacnean. Just take the Death to Mirror B and let the Meditite finish. But you might miss some ranges on Mirror B. Croconaw is like 80% to reset. Unless your Espeon is like amazing, like the one that I got in my PB, then it's more like a coin flip. Yeah, that's the worst part of Colosseum, is the croc resets. Today I've had two crocs and they've both been just terrible. And they've both been completely unrunnable, actually. The second one somehow was not a minus attack nature after doing 28 damage to Espeon with Shadow Rush, but it was 0 IV gentle. So, yeah. And then the first one was your classic, everything's really good, special attack is 36. SPE is speed. It usually, yeah, usually speed doesn't matter. Unless we are. There's only, two fights in the game where speed always... Only one fight in the game where speed always matters. And then there's one fight where it sometimes matters. And then there are several fights that it just depends on the shadow Pokemon IVs. And the lower your speed is, the more likely the shadow Pokemon outspeeds you. But you can always just get lucky and outspeed it. Oh wait, I forgot about Ein, but that's like only if you have really bad speed that it matters. Ein too. So I guess there's two. There's one fight where it always matters, and then there's two fights where it sometimes matters. But like this is the one IV speed, and that the Ein 2 fight is still gonna be fine. So I'm just on a level. And outspeed this army, so yeah. It's really nice to have good speed, but we can run pretty much everything that isn't the minus speed nature. I keep thinking Great Balls are on the top, because I keep missing Croc and then they are on the top. Maybe I'm meditating. Ooh, yes please. All of it. Well, special attack's low, but I did some calculations on ranges yesterday. So, I'm a little more comfortable with that. Just be adamant, please. Please don't be fucking careful. I'm gonna be so pissed that this is a careful croc, because this is exactly what happened to Paper Guy, where it's like, oh, this croc is really good, finally. And then it looks like it's not careful, but it is. It could be careful. It's basically like 1 in 4 that it's careful. Careful is so bad. It's just You have to run it. Well, with these stats, you have to run it, but then it just slowly kills you by not getting a diaper mode. You just can't call it. Never get this. But it's only, like, it could be impish, which is good, it could be adamant, which is good, it could be jolly, which is good, and it could be neutral, which is usually fine. Why is my controller not? That's weird. Neutral. I don't remember serious. I think it's fine. It's average. Sirius is not likely to get into hyper mode, so could be a problem. I just checked the VOD for it. Might not die. Okay. Just kill yourself, please. Oh, okay, yeah, that works too. Hyper mode this turn is great. Let's just get it out. Good. Grass 53, no. So is that actually a perfect fight? I think, well, you know, it wasn't a perfect fight because this time isn't very good, but I also fucked up movement because I'm bad. So I don't know. I don't know how long I was walking at, like, half speed because I was half paying attention to the program and trying to figure out my nature. Yeah, unfortunate that this is serious, but it's actually, like, not that bad compared to adamant, because it means my special attack won't drop off quite as much. I mean, I'd rather have adamant for the purification, because adamant give me more experience. Whatever. Okay, don't move from it. The number at the end of the, like, after grass, 53 is the power of hidden power if I teach it. Has a typing of grass. Power of 53. So we still don't know the chance of, like, snapping out of Viper mode. Obviously, with natures that are unlikely to get into Hyper mode in the first place, that's really bad. But if I don't snap out of Hyper mode, we should be in really good shape for the early game. This could be the god early game. This could be like a 55 Burma. Because I have every stat on Croc is really good for the early game. Special attack doesn't matter at all until you get to Relic Forest, so I mean, I don't want to set my expectations too high. Because the late game is where the fun is anyway. But I mean, I'm gonna struggle to keep up with my late game because I don't have hidden power on either. And I have bad speed on Espeon, so it would be really nice to get like a 112 Mirror B here, or at least a 113. Shadow Rush is 90 power. Yeah, in XD it's weaker. I think it's 55 in XD, but there's a bunch of shadow moves in XD. Is Shadow Rush... Maybe Shadow Rush is 90 in XD, but you don't start with Shadow Rush usually. It's like Shadow Blitz and that's 55. It's something like that. I don't remember though. Like in XD, Shadow moves are super effective against non-Shadow folks and not very effective against Shadow folks, so it's different. And then they don't critical like they do in this game here in the not gonna bother returning that. Okay, well, shit. Can that kill itself from there? So, not from there. It can do a lot of damage to itself, though. Oh my god, he actually did. Pure power is OP. He might have gotten a damage roll. Much. Meditate only has that's weird that he killed himself in there. Is there some weird calculation going on with pure power? It's 58 attack, 34 defense. milk attack. Yeah, we have both extended. Good crit luck so far. Yeah, it wouldn't be as interesting. Still haven't missed that range. Just stop doing this strat and just start playing for the bag on range. Strat is so slow. This strat protects against not critting really well. Yeah, this isn't gonna be a 55 firm, I don't think. Maybe. It's okay. It'll be a 112 mirror B if I don't get trolled, but. Really. There's no way it's not a 113 mirror B unless something terrible happens. Yeah, I think it would always bubble beam because like its other moves don't have any other priority. Like Shadow Rush and Takedown and Supersonic. It'll always just choose the most damaging move, unlike in Gen 3 where I can just derp out and like switch to a bad move. The exception being accuracy. Not actually good. Not great for purification, just... I hope I don't die to Mirror B. Fuck. It's fine. See there, that was the Bravo like guy where he just sits on the Pokemon after he gets through this. So this is actually the same number of turns. Wait, Surskit? I forget whether he can get back, but like, he's not gonna kill with that. It's fine. Yeah, I don't think we lost any time there. The Pineco range really helped. This is an example of a, this is a situation where it's like really efficient to double team Memorade. You have like basically a 20% chance of getting a one turn fight, which can save a lot of time. And I should be able to tank a Thundershock, because I'm definitely taking the heal after this fight. Not skipping this heal. It's 94% on Teo, yeah, 41% to kill Remoraid, and 50% to kill Magnemite. Man, I really wanted to go for that. I haven't plugged in my shifted AI stuff yet. We have no shifted AI this run. I don't see what special Espeon. Confusion. Am I supposed to confusion? Barboach. I didn't see which combo that was, so I had to. I'm gonna be at what, 76 roughly? 75? A rough skin goes after. So 75. Obviously dead to a critical. Got the good enough special attack and speed for Voltorb. I'm actually potentially alive though if I get Let's see. Where is... Oh, wait, that's the wrong Magnemite. Fuck, it's 45 to 54 and 18 to 22. So, 63 to 76. Yeah, I'm YOLOing. I'm YOLOing. I actually think this is the correct play. It's just a little bit scary. Just get the Remoraid range. Just get the Remoraid. Get him. Get him. Never! He's always that high, dude. How am I taking max damage everywhere? Every fight is 6. Alright, well, as long as I hit the range and don't get crit, well, this is fine. Strike isn't gonna kill plus one. Actually, he will kill with double quick attack. Zero. Yeah, he is gonna kill with double. The damage rolls on Shadow Rush and the high Thunder Shock roll. Just use. First kill for the larva. Get it. I have to switch out if he... Oh, Leer, not Owl? That's... still be fine. Easy! Zero damage on this fight. Thank you, Glitch. Okay, you've gotta be kidding me. Like, this game is dumb sometimes. You've gotta be kidding me. You have got to be joking. The hitboxes in this place. Wow. You don't ever skip that heal. Now, like this, I haven't lost any time on this. Like, there hasn't been a single fight this run that hasn't gone perfectly or. Like, that hasn't gone as planned, or better. The only fight where I got, or I didn't get a good critical, it didn't actually cost any time. There have been some close calls. So I'm gonna die if I don't crit. This has happened before. I've had a run perfect for 45 minutes. I'm gonna get wrecked in the late game. Low EXP on Croc, bad speed on Espeon, no hidden power. This is definitely gonna struggle to keep up with my PB. but you should save a lot of time in the early game. Don't do it. Good. Alright, this is the fight that's lost some time in previous rounds. Yeah. 55% range on the horsey. Please kill for once. Never! Never kill the horsey man. Alright, I'm gonna have to do this. Can't call Croc because he's in hyper mode. And there's no point in shadow rushing the sand troop because it's guaranteed to die to confusion and it can't die to shadow rush. So I have to waste the turn somehow, and with the potion I can save a menu later. But that just always wastes so much time. Yep, speeds. After the dragon dance. And he has flail, and I cannot afford to take damage on Croc, so that's why I don't give it a turn there, even though it would be faster. Crits. Health is easily good enough. So unless we get really bad luck, we should be fine on ground now. Thank you. there's pretty much no way that this is a 56. The 6 is really solid. Something weird happens. I don't know what, like, I don't think I can pick a 5. It's like, the fight that I do on Firma now is, like, really consistent. It's either you get extremely unlucky and die, or you just get a consistently average fight. Considering how brutal that RNG in that fight is, perfectly fine with that. Yeah, it's... There's bad attacks, so I'm not gonna do paper cuts, but that's something fine. Should have rushed him. Yeah, the big... It's not even a big risk, but what we really don't want to see here is critical. It's just time loss. Critical bubble beam for Mantine. This could cost us like 20-something seconds. Speedfall bubble beam is fine. Okay, now if he crits us, he probably won't... Yeah, he's not going to kill us with a crit. But he might cause us to have to heal twice instead of once. Cursor's on. That's a weak Mantine, it would have worked. Better about Kulava route. I think we'll have enough speed to the end of that. This fight fucking sucks. Like, I might just switch to paper guy straps from now on. Like, if you don't crit there, it's like it was fucked. But paper guy straps are even slower normally. No, I said no way it wasn't 56. But I didn't think it would barely be 56. Please die. Okay, that is one reason that this X special strat is so good, is that the crit usually doesn't punish you. It's a damage range. I guess I can skip Viper Potions here, can't I? Wasn't thinking. Because I've only used one Super Potion so far. No, after two bars have cleared, then it starts getting EXP. Coin flip time. Big thing is that we don't want Menotype to kill Croc here. That breakout doesn't matter too much as long as it gets in the second ball and doesn't kill Croc. Out here, we have to go down to Pokeballs. Very nervous when this situation comes up. Come on. Yes. Alright, queen fight. Where are my X? My X special, yeah, so it should be 3. Every time. Literally every time. Cannot remember that I'm on Pokeballs. I always remember everything else, but not that I'm on Pokeballs. It's so annoying. And I didn't remember to check Metatite stats either. No. Okay, we are going to do Paper Guy strats on the next fight. Not this one, but the next one, because I think they're just better. Like, Swablu is too annoying. Come on. Yeah, no, bad, bad. Crit anyway. One shot of damage. YOLO. Oh my god, didn't even come close. Miss. Okay, that's better than Espeon, maybe. It's actually really bad. First thing, first bad thing that's after this run. Croc doesn't really benefit at all from coming out here. I guess he gets a little bit of the XP, but the Shadow Bar was fine. So no meta type is really bad. Can't do anything about it though. I can't use Croc on the next fight, it's way too important. Saved him nearly. Even though I have the perfect setup for Mirabi, I just can't afford to. Croc take damage. So yeah, now I have to use poverty strats on this fight and hope Swablu doesn't troll. Swablu will not die now that I'm out of type mode. But Lotad will, unless I have horrible attack on Meditite, which is possible because I didn't do very much to that stars. They have good special attack. Can you just get the swap loop for once? I'm confused at itself. Alright, there we go. If you crit, not in hyper mode. Oh, it is a good benefit. Wait, I'm dead if he goes into hyper mode. It's lost like a minute plus on these two things. Yeah, this is not even a good run anymore. What a joke. Just got absolutely wrecked by bad Metatite RNG. And it wasn't even a bad, like, stats Metatite. Fucking 2 minutes, basically. I guess, like, I could have helping handed it on the Zelda, would have been faster. Not thinking there was any chance it would kill all. It's like, oh, all confusion. Time is not even good at all now. It's frustrating, but it's frustrating, like, it probably isn't gonna PB now. Like, I just lost so much time to those two fights. Can always make it up here, but not having good special attack or hidden power or anything just makes the late game so garbage. Alright, so now this is gonna come down to a speed tie. Which is weird that I routed it like this, but I guess it makes sense. So basically need to win a coin flip here. Use it or... Okay, so that'll die. Just need to win the coin flip. Okay, now just crit. Okay, no leech seed. Run, what's on? Omega drain. No, no, no. Okay. That's good. Good, good, good. This is probably gonna be a big out fight if I crit this turn. Or if I don't crit and he hits himself, I probably won't do enough. Well, rain isn't even gonna fill up here. This classic situation. 63, okay. More important is the undead off of here. Yeah. Probably will kill. It's annoying, but fine. Rain's done this turn, so that's a really good fight. Kept Kron. So yeah, that fight saved the average mirror B fight, and this is probably not gonna be PB. Okay, But yeah, I don't know. Ryzik and Paper Guy, do you think it would just be better to, like, not bother with Metatite on the previous two fights? Because the last two runs, I've, like, just had a... lost so much time because Metatite just wouldn't get into hyper mode, or it got into hyper mode and then it died, and then, like, Metatite, you know, died to Swablu or the Beldum. It's just Metatite was not doing its job at all. And I guess because, you know, of all the shit that Dunsparce and, like, Dunsparce and Swablu, but the other Pokemon can kind of hurt Metatite as well. Like, Thundershock from Mareep actually does, like, 30%. Or more. It's just... if Metatite gets beat up, then it's not really useful. If Espeon gets beat up, then potentially die. I just cannot... how is that miss... hitboxes in this game. I'd kind of rather just risk proc. But, and then, like, problem is proc just dies to mirror, but it's not like proc might die or is slightly more likely to die to mirror B if you use him for the second fight. He just does die to mirror B. You just have to route around him dying. The first fight, like, he's better than Metatite because he's already in hyper mode, and you can just kill the Mareep turn one. Or play for the one, you know, 5 and 6. But then Metatite's not in hyper mode for the second fight if you use Croc for the first fight. Now, I might just start doing that though. I might just start using Croc for the first fight as long as he has enough health to tank like a takedown. Just so I can get rid of that damn Dunsparce faster. And then, like, if Croc gets hit, I'm Mareep and switch out. And Metatite can maybe get hyper mode on one of the turns. It's really not. Okay, so what are we doing here? I have bad attack. Go for the Carvana range. I guess I just go for the Carvana range. What's up, Fred? This range should be favorable, but it's weird. Return is not at full power yet, so I don't know exactly what it's at. See, Metatite did a lot to Beldum, right? He just did a lot. So I'm assuming my attack is really high. Like, he can't do that much to Beldum if his attack isn't really high. So I'm gonna go for the Shroomish range here. Just please get in the thing. And then I don't know for the next fade, I'm just gonna use Rock. So first, Cacnea is 88% to go down. Shroomish is gonna be like a coin flip or maybe 70%. Nice, that's really good luck to start this turn. I need to get Kraken for the next fight. Even though it's gonna lose a little bit of time and animations. Croc needs to take damage to get Torrent, and Croc needs to get some experience. Shadow Rush Return Ball Toy, Shadow Rush Return Ball. Into Confusion Croc here, okay, that's still faster than this. So basically, perfect fights, except Croc is at high health. Also, Croc is barely, he's barely gonna get purified in time. Dang. Because I didn't use it for the first suit. He will, I'm pretty sure he will, because of the walking. It's close. For this. I'm not gonna do much to myself in confusion, I'd be like 35 or 42. Some high special defense. Yeah, it would have been a lot better, Paper Guy. I don't know what if you saw the two fights with Metatite before Mirabee, but they were awful. Metatite is just not coming through for me there. Just keeps getting status and killed and not getting into hyper mode at the right time, and then getting into hyper mode when I wanted to just attack. So I might just switch to Croc strats for the first fight, and then just second fight, I don't know what I'll do, like just Metatite and not hyper mode. Of course, I saved a lot of time on this split because Metatite was in hyper mode. So you never want to like skip out on Metatite getting hyper mode, but I hate when he gets into hyper mode at the wrong time. Alright. Why not? Okay, yeah, Firma was kinda slow, but no trolling, and then Mirabee was perfect, except the two Metatite fights were terrible. Shatterish Hornet. Okay. Stop. Do anything here. Like, there's no way I can get proc a turn. This plant throw can't get critical anyway, so like, it's just, I have to just deal with 10. That's gonna go to 10. It's gonna go to 34. Also, how the fuck was that split so good? Was that an 11? 24? Okay, so I don't need to revive. 34 out of 110 is 37 out of 113, so that is actually perfect. I thought it would be too high. It's just barely torrent. Wow, this run. Two fights sucked in this run. Everything else has been perfect. Except my silly little movement errors. And hitboxes. It's like less silly movement errors and more silly hitboxes. Yeah, why did Hitman top triple kick? Croc. Like, that was weird. Defense is what, 20? Defense is really good. Espeon's defense is not that much. I don't understand that. I think I just don't. Serious? 120. Wow, serious nature is garbage. Oh, this is gonna be awful. That's it? I didn't even die to Mirabi. Yeah, fuck using Meditate, man. For Dunsparce fight, I need my EXP. That's so bad. Like, we're gonna start bleeding time, and it's just gonna keep getting worse and worse and worse and worse. I don't have any way to, like, salvage this. Because I need speed for Starmie, so I can't just not keep the XP share. How much time does it take to fight an optional trainer? Thank you. 8 special attack and 12k. Ugh. God. Venus will be fine. Well, maybe Venus won't be fine with the special attack range. Coin flip. A range on the net at plus 9. Steelix is not going to be a range. It's like 11 and 16. I don't have it for 8. I have it for 10, and that's 77%. So it's favorable. I mean, it's just... I don't know what he does. I think he just, like... I think it's just... I think I get level for the next 12 toy, but it's fake. It's a lower level. I think this ball toy range is like the only one I really need to worry about here. Unless I get Marsh Stomp. Marsh Stomp just hit. One speed on Espeon is going to make the lab awkward. My special attack is garbage, so I can't do lab torrent strats. So ranges coming up are well. There's the ball fight. It's just out of range. Not too much. Well, there's the Lily. Actually, am I gonna be 35 for Spinda? I think so. Pretty sure I will be, so I'm not gonna die to Sandstorm plus Psybeam, I don't think. Yeah. Wait, which fight is this? Is this three? We got two more fights. Yeah, we'll get it. The next fight is a ball toy, so that's range. So yeah, ball toy, favorable range here, and then the sand slash is an unfavorable range, but it might not matter if I get sand slash lead, and then we have the other sand slash, which is just not a range, just a final secret. And then if we get marsh taunt, then I don't fucking know. Well, it's not going to do the special attacks well. So the range is so bad. Do I even get 36 for ducking? I might not. Also, can I even do fight strats to try to save the ether? Fuck, I don't remember it. Dude, I might switch to Hyper Beam. I don't like this special attack. HP grass. Fucking 30% range on the clay doll. The double protect. This is nasty. Barboach. Yeah. Like, it's the same strats. The whole run is the same strats. It's just ranges everywhere that normally are either non-existent or extremely visible. And with bad speed on Espeon. Problem too. Alright, so we don't get Sandstorm, so we don't have to worry about somehow dying to Confusion without crit. Pretty sure Lily will still die. Here. If it won't, then I guess I can just... Wait, no. It's not... Psybeam, and then, yeah, I have to do Crystal Strat. I'm gonna do it. According to my notes, I hope they're not wrong, the range is good enough. Yeah, I played it as a kid several times. Oh wait, does Kadabra have a chance of living here? Is that the problem with this? Fuck, he might be. Okay, that should be good enough. But even if Spinda lives, it's fine, right? Cause, yeah, whatever heroes. So now we're good on Serps for sure. Yeah, well, it's like a range with no bite does not even kill, even if you have plus special attack. Torrent Serp does way more than bite, but like I don't. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, fuck this special attack, man. That's what I was worried about. But it's just time loss, like the block thing. I vaguely remember that now. Remember it being like always, even with good special attack range or really close. That's fine. And I get the good combo when it's not. So what is it? Boy, Espeon is at 94. Get in. Ooh, nice. Defense. Yeah, I'm not gonna do all this. See, I used one super for... what? Where did I super? For Mirror B, two. So I should have three supers left and, like, three potions. Three supers, three potions. So I need to, like, double super Gator, probably. 81 is kind of... 81 okay? Trying to remember Marsh Top strats. What do I want to be for Marsh Top? Do I want to be at 81? Marsh Top is such a shit show. I just don't want to consider it at all. Can I return coffee? Like, I just don't have anything for Marsh Taunt. It's just, don't get Marsh Taunt and steal the strat. Unless you have good special attack. And even then, I don't know. 81. Am I gonna level? Like, I wanna be safe against critical... critical EQ plus psychic. My notes don't say how much EQ does, so they have psychic only. Oh no, they do. They don't have psychic, but they do have keys, so it's like 20 to 24. So then I'll be at, like, at lowest, like 40-something. Or no, lowest, like, 35. Crit? I'm too scared, dude. I don't know if return kills her. It should. Only the toes. And I just search those. Because my notes say red. It's like yellow where he's living before. So I don't have to ether. That's all I need to do. God, I always feel like there's more to do before this fight. And it varies. Sometimes you have to heal Espeon, sometimes you have to ether, sometimes you have to like hyper potion and super potion, or hyper potion and potion, so your cursor goes all over the place. I don't see camera touch, you don't see camera touch. Camera ups. Okay, this is the faster version. This does matter, because I didn't get the hyper potions. Oh god. Oh no. This is bad. It wouldn't have mattered if he didn't crit, right? Defenses. Let's just hope it's enough. If Entei's plus special attack, I might be dead. This doesn't fucking kill, which by the way, I needed that crit to win this fight. They're skipped. like, just at fuck Marsh Tom with a passion, dude. Somehow didn't even lose that much time, but now I have one super. Not even that bad of a split. Fuck Marsh Tom with a passion. Hate Marsh Tom, man. The reason I hate Marsh Tom is that the route, the optimal route changes if you get him, but you don't know whether you're going to get him, and it's only 1 in 3 to get him. I mean, the good news about Marsh Tom is that I am now good on X specials the rest of the run no matter what, so I can, like, X special instead of opening hand on E-Vice and stuff like that. Yeah, the triple kick from Hitman Top, I really saved that split, so I didn't have to revive, and then I got the Tripping Train, which is just basically perfect split other than the Marsh Tomp, and then just a couple of chip breaches. Ugh, bad. Thank you, Tate Man. This dude. Now, unbelievable. I'm actually talking to the guy. Actually talking to him. Why am I going out this way? Oh my god. Man, just not taking inputs. Pressed. Hey. And three revives. I feel like I want more. I have 3 already. Do not understand. introduce that much lag. So, about new Venus strats, I do have... actually, I don't know that I have the special defense for it. I might have not... My special defense might be too good to get Torrent from Vileplume. I want to do YOLO Vileplume strats. I'm trying to think, are there any ranges with Vileplume? With this special attack that I would want to avoid by doing the YOLO strat. I mean, the YOLO strat is not really smart, honestly, with no hidden power. But what is the Vileplume strat? I want to say there is... This is terrible movement. I want to say there is a range on the Banette. But I gotta check to make sure that Gator even takes enough damage from, Giga. 68 to 80. But that's with level 37. Whatever happens if I'm over. Is my health 116? Oh, that's dicey. I think we want Steelix here. Okay, well, let's just... did never get to check the weapon range because just level 36 fucks me on this fight so many times. But I like it. As long as Steelix dies, which it should. Internet might be down. If it is, so be it, I can't do anything about it. So that was really nice to get the Steelix combo. Steelix is ideal with that special attack. How long can this run survive? It's got a nice lead, but I mean, I don't want to fucking die twice and get a 1 minute PB. I know that I would beat my goal time if I did that, but I don't want it. It doesn't have to be like that, man. We can just have a little bit of time loss, double protect on Dakin 2, whatever. Just nice and easy, get a nice 3 minute PB, 2.5 minute PB, whatever. There's no dumb shit. I've had it happen so many times where like the run is in really nice shape. Don't even need good luck, just need to not die, and then it all falls apart, so... Yeah, Teddy Ursa, Shroomish. Surf, Psybeam, Shroomish. Okay, this is good. Yeah, I mean, it's a good early game, but I can beat that here. It's not by 2 minutes. Just need to have plus attack nature. Missing the horsey range, not getting the one turn directly at Magnemite and stuff like that. Not expecting that luck, but when you get the good attack, it's like overall good for the run, and that section is way faster. No, I got Croc first ball and Meditite second ball, and Meditite second ball barely loses time to first ball. It's like 5 seconds. Ooh. Okay. Let's both die. Thank you. Yeah. Like, the corrupt time is just about what it should be if you first fall. The fiery Colosseum time. Honestly, I think my strats on the fight, the last fight there are slower than, like, just the golden strats where you, like, usually miss the range. It's just you have to get the bag on range, otherwise you do lose time. So, yeah, I can save probably, like, 20 seconds on that fight. I mean, if I hit a good attack, you just one hit the gold beam. And then in Firelight Colosseum, you just get the one hit the Magnemite. And then one hit the Horsey, one hit the Apom. There's so many free time saves from having a plus attack nature that I don't think this early game is, like, really bad to compare against. It just requires plus attack to win. And plus attack is like the future of the crop route anyway. Like, if you're going for a god time, it's hard to do it without plus attack. Or hidden power. And if I have hidden power, then I don't care if I'm behind this early game, because I can make up so much in the late game. Well, that might live. That might live as the tourney has ended. Boy, that would be annoying. That'd be really annoying if that lived. Where is my cursor? Should be on X special. Up one. Please die. Okay, good. Good. No damage. Got my EXP. Artillery Masquerade, that is perfect. So I have bad speed. Just need no side control. What is the thing that I'm doing with the revive? Type in exclamation point item glitch in chat. Or, sorry, new glitch in chat. Damn it, I'm on Ryzik. Ryzik involved with the item glitch, so it's new glitch. Thank you. So the exploit is, like, you use the revive when it doesn't work. And then it allows you to use an X item on the Pokemon it didn't work on. How long is it new? Oh my... Are you serious? No fucking way. Oh my god. Wow. Wow, that's like so fucking favorable. Wow. That's a range without the X special, okay. Oh, dumb. Wait, this is not optimal is to go talk dirt instead. Alright, whatever. Anyway, that's fucking dumb. You know what else is dumb? Bad special attack in this fight. It's all survivor, it's 50. Jesus. God, I'm still 37. Thing. Tempted to do nothing on Gator's turn, but I'm just gonna. I might just improv this fight, I think this is stupid. Can it even do enough damage with Surf, I don't think. He sends out Loud Red, maybe with Force Law. Yeah, I'm just gonna not even bother with it. Well, how much does this do? Yeah, I didn't even do enough. So I'm improving. Time here, probably. Whatever, whatever, it's gonna be four turns either way. Well, I lost basically 45 seconds to the special attack there. Like, this, I don't think there's much I could have done. I lost more than 45 seconds. Well, speed. I lost more than 45 seconds, but some of it was from speed. That is ugly. 12 minute analysis. Unbelievable. Right there. That's crazy. Like, I actually had the defense to tank the sneak along if it didn't matter. Please get out of it. But like, my notes say to do Surf plus Protect, and then Surf returns Sneasel. And then that's supposed to kill both Loudred and Sneasel, and neither of them would die there, because Loudred... So it's 37 for Loudred. So like, it was more the experience than the bad special. This is a good learning experience, but I mean... It's just margins. If I just had a little bit more special attack or a little bit more experience, it wouldn't have been a problem. Like, this is how this run was supposed to go, though, mostly. Other than, like, maybe I need to adjust my strats to get Croc that experience on the Dunsparce fight. Like, that's... Whatever. I thought Serious Nature would be better. I thought I would get more than this. Serious Nature, it shouldn't have been as bad as it is, so I think this is just another case of the strategy guide and the Dragonfly. What's it called? Dragon... That site. Dragon, the site that I use that has the purification guide, I think it's just not detailed enough about the purification rates, because there's no way that this was just normal. This had to have, one of them had to have been bad, or something. No, that's not it. Do here now. Six. Fuck, dude, that's not gonna be enough. I'm not even gonna bother. I'm gonna do it somewhere else. There's no way it's off. It's not. He's not gonna do enough. It's like guaranteed to not do enough to put me in. But I can't do lap touring. It's just Magnemite just, or Magneton just won't die. It's just dead if I do that. Actually, wait. I could try it. Lap Torn is so suicidal with this. I already got Blizzard, but I suppose I was supposed to get Blizzard anyway. There's other ways that I can get this all. I'm just gonna have to figure it out. This is not the optimal way on this run, because Voltorb doesn't even die to Surf. Use 6 seconds plus paralysis. Hitboxes. Okay, can I do lab torrent? Like, is there any chance lab torrent will work? What are the ranges again? I really want to do it because I've got the defenses. Like, finally I have really good defenses for it. I don't see a thing up there. I want to do it. Psychic does 92 to 109. Fuck it, I'm gonna do it. Who did I get? What was this combo? A Farmer Guard. Special Psychic A Farm. Yeah, fuck it. Going for it. Should be okay. I can't think of anything better. It's just all it is a special attack. Just have to get good ones. Surf Psychic Gator. Okay, if these things don't die. Range is so awful, man. I hope I just get the fucking magnetite on your farm. This is... can't do anything. Can't remove. Okay, there's the thing. Magnemite, Magneton. Yes. No ranges. And if we crit Magneton, then we're kind of dead. Glad we could heal. How much is the Electrode gonna do? Is he not gonna kill me? Well, he would not kill me from full. I maybe could have just tried to tank a Thunder instead, whatever. Like, I have not had a run that can tank a Thunder in so long. Oh, I can slash Carvana. Yeah, I'll do that. Wait, I don't have slash. Fuck, why didn't I teach... Oh, god. Okay, well, not doing that. Just haven't been thinking about Lab Torrent. So just get by on defense, I guess. Where is this in my notes? Light. Surf because Hound Hour kills from here. That's their fight. But I can save damage on this. See it. Has to die, but it won't die because I have no bubbles or special attack. And Espeon continues to not take damage. Yeah. definitely do pussy strats on the next fight. Or not the next fight, but the one after. I was checking for... I'm gonna do it again here. Gonna check for... DNA sample to open the door. How in the world do I not have any of these left? What? That's not gonna die. That is... there's no fucking way. Where did I use extras? Where did I use extras? Oh my, how in the fuck is that possible? No, how did I use extras? You're supposed to have two here! And I had Torrent. I feel so shit. Is pretty much dead. Just don't know how to run bad special attack. Just get over the fucking vigor off range. Didn't remove the spoon. Oh dear. Didn't put on the spoon. Still lived anyway, so... excellent! Zero... wow, that's epic. Well, cool. This run is actually dead. It's that's sad, but honestly, I'm not surprised. Excellent. Zero DNA samples anywhere. It's probably on the other damn side. Didn't equip the spoon. Dead. Yes, dude. Yes. It, like, torrent. That torrent is so stupid. It's so stupid. All you have to do is just not do that torrent. They just lost the running out of this. Fantastic. I don't even remember this. Epic. It's not even close normally. You're not even close to 39, and now I'm dead. Actually incredible. 39 for Magneton. How does... Wow, so I... Yeah. Not doing this again. Not doing this again. Like, I am not routing. I'm not getting 12k experience ever again with bad special attack. This is horrible. It's just horrible. Holy shit. I mean, I guess I'll do it now. And try to do this. Then again, I'm level 39, so it's probably gonna be a rematch. And then that wasn't it. It's not at all. Dead! Cool. Well, that's it. Lesson learned, whatever. It's actually not that hard to get a run like this again. It's just so annoying. Like, that the margins are that thin. It's just game over. He's gonna kill. faster. Yeah, I'll finish, but I'm not gonna PvP, because at this point I just don't know how to handle everything that's happened. This is ridiculous. Like, I'm probably just gonna die to this. Okay. Hello? I'm not gonna PvP, that's it. Like, what threw me off is not having level 38 for the Sneasel fight. That I've never seen before, except runs where, like, Gator died. Like, that just was like, what? Since when? Since when do you not get 38 for that fucking fight? On a good nature with no death to near be. Just like... Is serious nature just documented wrong, or do I think normal purification is, like, different than it is? I don't know. But... Just, I had to start improving basically right after Venus with everything because of how little EXP I had. Alright, don't be a dick in room dance, please. This is a good fight. I don't get it. Room dance. Well, it's a good fight if I don't. Thank you. Excellent. 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 I hit 1 out of 5 blizzards this run. It's not done yet. 1 out of 5 blizzards. And every miss mattered a lot. Do you do call strats on Sirius? Like, I can't believe I only got 12k. That just seems so low. Considering, like, the two fights where I used Meditite. Yeah, that just seems way lower than it should be. And it makes me wonder if there's some mechanic that we're not considering, because... like, I used Croc for all of Mirror B. I used it for one Pokemon or two Pokemon. No, two Pokemon on the Dunsparce fight. You gotta get XP because Meditite died. And all of Scrub and all of the fight before Scrub. So the only places where Croc missed EXP were the first two fights of Relic Forest, and that's just Espeel, Carvana, Shroomish, and Akakia. So it's not big experience pokes at all. And yeah, that was it. The only places where Croc doesn't normally get EXP that it does. Because, like, when I did my test run, like, a month, or no, it was, like, a little less than a month ago, I got 17k EXP with Naughty. So do I really get 4,500 extra EXP because of nature? What, over, like, a great nature over a good nature? I do not remember it being that much. That's just... it made such a big difference this round. Come on. Here. What's up, guys? Stats are okay. Nice, how'd it go? Croc's nature ended up fucking it this run, and special attack. Serious nature is worse than I thought. Am I even going? Meant to be down there. Okay, fine. One protect. A good roll, so I'm a skill for it. No, it's too slow to purify anything after you get the time. Oh god, you got level 42, just kill the fucking plate all day. Why would Suicune be good for a speedrun? Okay, I know Suicune is... a good competitive Pokemon, but what makes it good for a speedrun where the goal is to go as fast as possible rather than just have as strong of a team with a high chance to win as possible? Thank you. So coverage for Mount Battle. Coverage for late game actually favors fire types. Mount Battle is so much faster with a water type. Specifically since you have Surf and it targets both. And they're all weak enough to die. God damn it. No you don't get the Master Ball, it's too big of a deal. Save time if it works. I I mean, it'll work, just I have to fuck around with it. Sure. I think it works, but it might take damage. I think this was right. Just don't kill the right shield. How long am I gonna play it? For today, another like 40 minutes. Much damage. This could be just possible, actually. Twenty-seven, you son of a bitch. You son of a Okay, that's really annoying. I mean, I guess we just have to go for the range now. Traditional games. Like, to me, this is every bit as traditional as the other games. I don't feel like that. I don't know what. I don't think about it that way, but I don't know what my next project will be exactly. Dude, if I get 1 in 16 right here and I die, I'm gonna be so salty. I think I actually am gonna get fucking one-shotted and have to potion. Fight if he lives. But I was thinking about using Protect on Gator, because he should be one-shotting it, but I'm just not positive he'll one-shot here. I kinda wanna find out. But, like, my notes are kind of weird about... Like, there was an old route that did this fight much earlier, and so Proc is at a lower level. So then, like, I think even though I got lost so much EXP this run, I think my level is about the same, or possibly higher than what it was when I did these calcs, which means Vile Swine might not kill me, and then I couldn't protect. So just please kill the fucking Vile Swine. It's like a good range. So we got just no Starmie. Wussel's already dead. We'll save time on Evice unless we get full restore or miss the Tyranitar range. So we just need to not get Starmie here and then hit two blizzards on Godzap, and we're in pretty good shape to PB, but obviously hitting two blizzards is not in your favor, so we ain't. Reminder that I've hit 1 out of 5 blizzards this round. My luck has been really good, except that. Okay, good. Terrible special attack is fine. Starmie will still die, don't worry about it, Starmie not dying. Did I? Lag. Okay, I gotta remember if I crit this, then I can just skip the X special. Do that strat, so protect X special otherwise. Crit, okay. Protect, just psychic it. Alright, that's really annoying, but it should be okay if I. Because I got level 53, which I was always thinking of anyway. I don't know what my psychic is gonna be like. That's a nice hitbox. And what? Wait, didn't I go up? That's faster. Good. So return is not next kill, so it's two of them. And then Hariyama gets hit by a surf on the way in, so he's dead to another surf. Barely, but still. Espeon can tank too. That's no guarantee. Need to heal. Teach EQ and the hyper potion meter. Probably gonna be in range, not sure. And I'm gonna just this. So don't forget later. So this will be time loss on this split from that extra menuing. Then I'll save it on the next split. Next split is what? Hello? 1545. So if I miss Blizzard, or if I do the safe strat, then it's probably gonna be time loss. But I mean, I just need to not miss Blizzard here, and I should PB. Really just, the run basically comes down to the Blizzards, I think. Are you not concerned? Okay, Blizzard number one. And both of these might matter. My special types of garbage if it doesn't work. Oh shit, how much is this gonna do if it puts me at higher than 50? Okay, I did a decent amount. Go up. Okay, I can take that. Oh god, I have no fucking clue what okay. We're just going to this, because I don't know what the fuck else to do. I'm just gonna hit the blizzard and it'll be fine. Shifted AI in the middle of a fight. Fucking fun, man. Death, I guess. Ooh, maybe not. Please kill. Oh, that's so unfortunate. I'm dead now. Lost our senses. I can somehow... No, it's just not gonna outspeed. Why is it there? So what was it supposed to be? I was supposed to return the shiftery anyway, and he doesn't die, so even the strat that I was supposed to do according to the book would have gotten me killed there. Even hitting two blizzards, and it's just... bad special attack, just fucking owns. Owns you in the late game. Opposite. So this now comes down to whether I hit a blizzard and basically 30% damage. So I get the milk here. Level 46. Oh, let me. That feel when you might not even kill Absol with plus 2. Like, fuck if I don't kill it. What is. Sharpedo lives. I'm supposed to. Outspeed it. But I don't outspeed because I'm 20. Make it stop. Make it stop this run. I'm so mighty and I thank god I'm not throwing that fucking Sharpie dead. Well, I still do, maybe. Now I'm fine. I just had a level here. Alright, just give me an okay roll. It just has to be an okay roll, that day. Like, just okay. Just an okay roll. Just okay roll and definitely critical. Like, special cater. An okay roll. Don't even need a certificate, just an okay roll. A-okay. Yes! We did it! We did it! Oh wait, a Sharpedo might not die. Shit. Shit, I forgot about that. Well, okay. Also, I might get outsped. Don't get outsped. Okay, good. Yeah, I don't know that the Sharpedo is going to die now. I'm gonna outspeed it. Is it gonna hurt? Oh god, what is this? It's gonna hurt if I miss. That's not in my notes. Like, I was making note, like, I should have just put that in, I was silly, but not, but, like, that situation's so rare. This all started to go downhill with Marshtown, man. Fucking Marshtown. Oh, and now the Houndoom can live too, because I'm still 47. Everything is gonna live worse than me. 49 for TR. Wait. Not this strat again. this one. Before I got speed. That's not good. He's probably like bad speed before I let up get defense. Oh, crit him. Okay, instead we get the dogfight. Now, no problem. No problem. Outspeed Houndoom and kill at 47 and don't crit us again. Okay, so now the question is, what do I do? 52. Alright, I think I'll do Pansy strats, because I can afford it. I mean, and the YOLO strat is, like, really unlikely to work. So if I get Cradily lead, I'll do Pansy strats. I mean, I am fucked if I don't, like, hit the Cradily, or hit the Cacturne. On non-Pansy strats. Like, it's fine, it's not good. EXP loss probably will matter, but it's fine if I hit the blizzard and miss the range. It's not fine if I just miss the blizzard, because I've lost happiness on SBM, so return is going to do nothing. I have no choice now in the YOLO. YOLO strat is what we're going to do right now. Try to hit a blizzard and the unfavorable damage. No. Honestly, it isn't even that bad if Cacturne just criticals in here. Am I gonna get 48? Yeah, I'll get 48 there. Did so little. Guess you can tank two of those if you like levels. And I can't even do Surf Pansy strats here because I don't even have enough. I can't even do enough damage with Surf plus Return. The only thing I can do is Blizzard. Just hit the blizzard. Like, you've missed four already. Just hit the blizzard, and then if you die, it's not a huge deal. Hit the blizzard. Okay. Likely to live. Freeze. Meditite is dead. That's level 28 strats. Yeah, Pansy strats are like you heal, so Cacturne puts you into Torrent, and it's an extra turn, but then you kill it with Return plus Surf. But I didn't even have good enough stats for that. What's up, Kirby? Yeah, so we just need to not get trolled, and we're fine. Trying to think, the Blaziken ranges could be a problem. We'll be fine. This fight is easy. Not shifted AI. No Gardevoir Blaziken would be nice. So I've had this one before. I don't need to worry about Surf ranges. I do need to worry about Metagross EQ range. So just Metagross, don't be close defense or anything like that. 9 X specials. Don't do it. Good. Die. So now no freeze. Damage, critical will be fine. So that, that should do nothing except waste 6 seconds. I think I had this on one of my earlier PBs, that X special that turn. He can Fulorous, or he can Hyper Potion now, but I shouldn't hit any of his Pokemon below half. Unless I miss the Metagross range, but he can't heal that. Can't heal his Shadow Pope, so it should be set as long as I don't get, as long as I don't miss the Metagross range or crit myself with Earthquake here. See, I don't know what we want here. 56. I mean, it just, it all comes down to the Metagross stats, basically. Normally it's not such a concern, but since I have such a low level, it's just gonna come down to IVs in nature. If we get a crit here on a Metagross, that would be really good. Ooh, that did too much. Don't... Get Swagger. Actually, this is fine now. EQ will heal Gator. Okay, full restore is fine. Just get the Metagross range. Bad special attack and not much experience on this Gator compared to what I normally have. That is such a clean fight. I love it. Alright, 736 Evice. So that is 630. If I want to get sub 345, then I need to beat this. I need to get a 630, basically. So just no troll restore, no troll T-tar. But it might be more complicated because I'm level 49. We shifted it. Okay. Oh god. Okay. Get the range. 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 Or lose the speed power. Special Espeon Psychic Sounds. Get the range, get the range. Do not crit me. Chances to get crit. Ranges. Maybe I'll get 50 here. I'm gonna get 50. Huge psychic machine. Still no X attack, that's good. Please tell me I get 50 here, I don't think so. Seven doesn't matter too much. Alright, just critical. Just critical. Just critical the T-tar and sub 345. Okay, that's a good roll. Really better though. Coming down to one turn, the full restore turn. Or, except he doesn't even, can't even full restore. Okay, we win, I think. I think that's just it. That is PB. Unless. Unless I just YOLO for no good reason. No reason to YOLO this. Nice. This marks a very silly milestone that I've been keeping track of the past few months. But it's a PB as well. Obviously, bad run. Also, nice. Saving time to Espeon mode. There it is. Terrible run, bad special attack, serious nature, never again. Oh, we got it. .548, good stuff. No X attack on Evice. Easy fight. Easy fight. Routing on that fight has paid off so hard this month. But yeah. I mean, I'm not frustrated with, like, my play with the bad special attack. Just It's just, like, I don't know if I've run serious before, but I've never gotten that kind of experience when things have gone well before, so just wasn't expecting so many missed levels. Damage ranges on top of damage ranges. And then it did not help to miss four blizzards. Yeah, and remember I had to hit two blizzards on Dawn's app, Mistress, and then I hit the Cacturn, so I got very lucky at the end. Alright, that's a 12, not a 13. Good stuff, though. The journey to a good time continues. Alright, so the milestone, and I can't say that I've, like, fact-checked this. This is just going off of memory. And if my memory is wrong, then it's just an arbitrary milestone. But it's the kind of thing that motivates people for whatever reason. And it's something I was thinking about as this run was slipping, just trying to keep the run going for this. And that is, if my memory is correct, this marks 10 completed runs in a row that have gotten a world record. So the last 10 speedruns that I have completed have been a world record. The last one that wasn't was Crystal, when I was trying to beat Gunner's Time with Entei, and I missed it by about 10 seconds. Waiting for somebody to just point out some meme run that I did. I mean, obviously I did like a Charmander run, but that was a different category, so. But some silly run that I did one day that didn't get it, but if I remember correctly, that's kind of crazy, because, you know, it's not like I don't finish runs if they can't PB a record. It's just, I'll reset at the start for a decent start, and then whatever happens, happens. And it's just been lucky enough and kept my composure enough to be able to PB on some runs that didn't go quite as I planned. Yeah, see, like, it gets into technicalities like that, like the marathon run. And then, like, the Charmander run that I did for Red Blue. Where the goal was not to PB your record, it was just to do something different. So, like, it's not something I'm gonna be tweeting. Well, maybe I'll tweet about it, because... But it's not something I, like, think is any sort of accomplishment. I think it's just really cool to do that in, like, RNG-based games, plus Danganronpa, I did it twice. Yeah, Mistress, I used one extra on the Voltorb fight because my special attack was bad. I think that, well, I used one extra there, and then there still might be one missing, but we can just count it right now. One.